The Palestinian Health Ministry records the first case of polio in Gaza. According to health officials, it has detected the disease in the city of Deir al-Bala. The patient is a 10-month-old baby who had not received any polio vaccination dose. On Friday, UN Chief Antonio Guterres called for a humanitarian process in the Gaza war to conduct a polio vaccine campaign. A senior official warns the threat of the outbreak is not only confined in Gaza, but in neighboring countries as well through the contaminated raw sewage. Polio is a highly infectious virus that can invade the nervous system and cause paralysis. U.S. President Joe Biden says a deal for a ceasefire in Gaza is near after 10 months of bloodshed. The American president on Friday also warned all sides not to undermine efforts to push for a ceasefire.
Fire talks.
So far, as of an hour ago, it's still in play. I'm optimistic, not far from over. Just a couple more issues, I think we got a shot.
Are you more optimistic now than you have been in months past?
Yes.
He made those remarks as Secretary of State Antony Blinken was traveling to the Middle East to take part in ceasefire talks. During ceasefire talks on Friday in Doha, the U.S. presented a proposal to bridge gaps and begin a deal which would freeze fighting for an initial 6 weeks and allow for the release of Israeli hostages and Palestinian prisoners. The Palestinian death toll in the Gaza war has exceeded 40,000 this week. Filipinos urged to leave Lebanon as soon as possible as war looms over the Middle Eastern country. The Philippine Embassy in Lebanon advised Filipinos to depart while the airport is still operational. Those unable to leave are encouraged to move to safer areas outside Beirut, South Lebanon, and the Bekaa Valley. Tensions between Lebanon-based Hezbollah and Israel have escalated in recent weeks after a deadly rocket strike in the Israeli-occupied Golan Heights, which Israel blamed on Hezbollah. Israel retaliated by killing a top Hezbollah commander in Beirut. Today, Saturday, an Israeli strike in southern Lebanon killed 6 people. Philippine officials anticipate further Israeli attacks. There are over 11,000 Filipinos in Lebanon, 300 of whom have already returned home, while another 700 are awaiting voluntary repatriation. U.S. Democratic presidential candidate Kamala Harris enticing voters with economic commitments in her first major policy rollout. Speaking at a rally in North Carolina, Harris said she wanted to introduce new tax policies which will see taxes of most Americans decline. She also called for the construction of 3 million new housing units, with first-time owners set to receive up to $25,000 in down payment support. Harris also proposed a federal ban on corporate price gouging on food and groceries. The vice president is making a bid on the middle class as she draws contrast with a vision of her Republican rival Donald Trump, whom she painted as pro-billionaires.
The middle class is one of America's greatest strengths. And to protect it, then, we must defend basic principles, such as your salary should be enough to provide you and your family with a good quality of life. As president, I will be laser focused on creating opportunities for the middle class that advance their economic security, stability, and dignity. Together, we will build what I call an opportunity economy. An economy where everyone can compete and have a real chance to succeed.
The daughter of Thailand's disgraced former leader Thaksin Shinawat has become the country's youngest ever prime minister. Nearly two-thirds of Thai parliament elected 37-year-old Pettongtarn Shinawat. The political neophyte takes over the government 2 days after her predecessor Srettha Thawisin was dismissed by Thailand's constitutional court. World Health Organization is calling for a ramped-up mpox vaccine production to combat the spread of a more dangerous virus strain. The WHO recently declared the recent mpox surge a public health emergency of international concern, following an outbreak in Congo that has spread to Kenya, Rwanda, and Uganda. The health body is urging countries with vaccine stockpiles to donate them to those facing outbreaks. Meanwhile, the European Center for Disease Prevention and Control has raised its mpox risk level from low to moderate after Sweden confirmed its first case of the more transmissible mpox strain.
New cases in Sweden and in other countries are very, very probable. I mean, this is that we just have one case in Sweden. I mean, that is what was the chance for us. So new cases will arrive. And the most important thing is to both that people are aware of the risk when they are traveling in these areas, but also that the healthcare and other parts of the society are aware of the symptoms and very quickly can make the diagnosis and do the isolation and contact tracing and so forth, so we don't have a spread within the country.
A brawl erupts in the Turkish parliament. Ruling and opposition lawmakers got entangled in a fight as they discussed the fate of a jailed opposition figure. His fellow members of the leftist party defended Can Atalay from ruling party members and pushed for him to be admitted to the assembly. Atalay was sentenced to 18 years in 2022 after being accused of trying to overthrow the government. Parliament stripped him of his seat, but on August 1st, the Constitutional Court declared his exclusion null and void. Coffeehouse chain Starbucks is being sued for the third time by a company that accuses it of stealing its concept of coffee-flavored lipstick and lip gloss. Los Angeles-based LCC Balmaccino filed its complaint at Manhattan Federal Court Friday. It claims they pitched the coffee-flavored lip balms to Starbucks in 2018. Balmaccino alleged Starbucks stole its concept by launching the S'mores Frappuccino sip kit in 2019. Starbucks has yet to comment on the issue.